Okay, good morning students. Welcome to the session 9. The main essential components are 8. One is the engine. So engine is the heart of a diesel power plant. And next one is, so we need to supply the air for a combustion process. So air has some dust contents. So we need to remove the dust content, and also the concept of supercharging is available. Okay, so superchargers also we need to utilize. And next one is the after the combustion process, it takes the exhaust. So air entering process is a filter, and we need to, after the combustion, we need to remove the air through the exhaust system. So here we are using the silencers on most of the cases. And the second, fourth one is the fuel supply system. So we need to supply the fuel by using a fuel injectors. And next thing is a cooling system. So a diesel engine is a continuously operating means, it have a high amount of heat release rate, so that's why we need to reduce the temperature by using of a cooling system. Generally in a diesel power plants we are using water cooling systems. Okay, also some type of oils also we are using at a high combustion rate. Okay, if the heat release rate is very low, we are using the air cooling system. The heat release rate is very comparatively high when compared to the air small engines, that is at that time we are using the water cooling system. More than that, we are producing the high temperature, so at that time we can utilize some coolant oils also. Okay, nowadays most of the cars we are using the coolant oils instead of water for better cooling process. And we have a frictional losses here, so that's why we are using the lubrication system. Okay, and two more concepts we are using here. One is the starting methodology, starting system. So starting means for start the engine we need separate system. Okay, so generally in a normal engines we are using a cranking starting method, cranking. So by cranking the engine we can start the engine. Okay, and nowadays most of the cases we are using the self-start mechanisms. Okay, so that's why we would like to know about this, what is mean by self-start, what is mean by cranking in the latter cases. And the governing system. So most of the diesel engines are, agricultural diesel engines are operated at a constant speed. Okay, so the rotation of a diesel engine at a constant speed in a most of the agricultural diesel engines are power generating diesel engines. So how that speed is controlled by a unique speed. So here we are using the governor mechanism. So that governors are sending the fuel fluctuations. Okay, so if the speed is increases, it increases the flow of a fuel. If the speed decreases, it reduces the fuel flow rate. So based on the fuel flow rate control, we can maintain the constant speed of a diesel engine. That is happened in the governing system. Okay, so different types of governing systems we would like to learn in a dynamics of machinery subject. Okay, so here we can simply see the equipment here. What it mean by governing, how we can control the speed of a diesel engine. Okay, and coming to explanation of each component of a diesel engine power plants. So the first thing is the engine. So see here, this is the main component of the plant which develops the required power by burning of a fuel. Okay, by burning of a fuel which is directly coupled to the generator. So because the diesel engine contains a shaft mechanism, so this is connected to a generator directly. It is coupled with a generator. So here it is rotating means it generates the mechanical energy. That mechanical energy is coupled with a generator. So see the combustion process are already we discussed that in a diesel engine four processes happened. That is the suction process. So first one is the suction. Next one is the compression process. This is the expansion process of power stroke. And here this is the exhaust process. So see here, the first process is a suction process, blue lights, and this is a compressed air. After that we need to inject the fuel, compression, expansion, and last one is the exhaust process. So these are the processes. Okay, so these are the four cylinder mechanisms. So here we have different types of engine setups. Maybe single cylinder, dual cylinder, triple cylinders, four cylinders. So based on the power requirement, we can combine the engines. Okay, engine cylinders. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 cylinders here. 4 pistons here. So this is known as the piston. Okay. And the piston and the crank shaft is connected by a connecting rod. So this is the connecting rod connecting between the piston and the crankshaft. So this is the crankshaft here. That crank is rotating. So here we can see, observe that one stroke. Okay. So it gives 180 degrees revolution. Again it's moving up. Completed. 360. So total up. For 2 revolutions we are completing the stroke, 2 revolutions means 720 degrees. So it takes 720 degrees for the completion of a one power stroke. Okay, 2 revolutions and 4 strokes gives a high power energy generators. Okay, and see here the mechanism of valve mechanism. So the valves are open in two valves we have, one is the inlet valve and second one is the exhaust valve. So when the inlet valve is open, so when the air is entered into the cylinder, at the time the inlet valve is open, after that is closed. So the both are closed in a compression stroke. When the exhaust valve is open, at the final stroke, so initially suction stroke, inlet valve is open, in a compression and expansion stroke, both the valves are closed, and in the exhaust stroke, the inlet valve is closed and the exhaust valve is open. Okay, two openings here. Okay, and these are connected here. So this is about a engine, heart of the engine. So in this engine only we are converting the chemical energy into the mechanical energy. Chemical energy into the mechanical energy. And the next concept is the air filters. So what do you mean by air filter and why we need to the air filter system? So generally air filters remove the dust from the atmospheric air, okay, and which taken the engine, and supercharger is used to increase the pressure of a air supply. Okay, so if you increase the pressure or if you increase the temperature of a intake air, automatically it gives a high combustion rate of a heat energy release rate. Okay, so that's why we are using superchargers. So that means we are increasing the pressure of air intake air. So that is the, already we see in the initial stage compressor, we are using a compressor as a supercharging purpose for increasing the intake air pressure. So here air pressure increases the pressure of air supplied to the engine to increase the engine power. Okay, so here in this diagram we can see the air enters here, suited particles are there, some dust particles are there, so the dust particles are removed here and the fresh air is entered above this. So the fresh air blue lines are separating, and these are the solid contents. Okay, solid matter, we are removing the solid content and we are supplying the clean air here. After the filters we are supplying the clean air, otherwise it causes to the clogging of a pipelines and improper combustion takes place without air filter system. Okay, so that's the reason we need to clean the air filters continuously. Okay, so because already the air filters contain the so many dust particles, so that's the reason we need to remove it, then only it have a chance to again filtering capacity, otherwise it causes to the again sending it to the damage of a air filters also. So that's the reason we need to continuously monitor the air filters are cleaned or not, otherwise we can using the compressed air for the cleaning of a air filters. Okay, so air filters and the supercharging. And the next concept of diesel power plant is the exhaust system. So how safely we are taking the air into the combustion chamber, at the same condition we need to remove the exhaust gases, then only it have a space to occupy with a fresh air. Other than that we don't have a space to inject the air again. Okay, so that's the reason we need to remove the air continuously from the combustion chamber. So how we can remove that exhaust gases? So exhaust gases are generally removed by using of a silencers or that is connected to some ducts. Silencers and ducts are using to remove remove the excess gases. And here also the important thing is removing of the air is not only an important thing. We are removing the air excess gases with lower temperatures. That means we are reducing the temperatures, because if it is having very high temperatures, it causes to the environmental pollutions. And also we need to remove some dangerous gases before entering into the environment. So like a sulfur dioxide or nitrous oxides, we need to remove the inside the system only. Okay, how we can remove or how we can convert it? So we are using a catalytic process for reducing the impact of a harmful emissions. Okay, so by using of a catalytic process inside the silencers, so we can remove clearly, and then we can inject into the atmosphere. Okay, so this is the silencer part. So in this silencer part, we are remove the exhaust gases and it is released to the atmosphere. Okay, and the next concept here, fuel supply system. So it is also very important. Already we discussed that. So the fuel injection is the most important thing, because we need diesel in the form of a liquid format, but it doesn't occupy the entire space properly. So that reason we need to compress the diesel. At a compression stage, we are supplying the fuel injector, so that compresses around a pressure of 200 bar in a normal cases. In a CRDL engine, that pressure is around 600 bar. So what happened if the pressure is increases? If we are increasing the pressure, automatically the atomization range is increases. So if the atomization is takes place in a proper way, the combustion of a fuel is a very good manner. For that process, we need to utilize the fuel pumps and the fuel injector mechanisms. Okay, so we need to, so see here the operating of a fuel injection system. So these are the injection systems here. So in this system, we can see the some spring here. So that spring gives the compression ratio. If you want to increase the injection pressure, if you just turn the spring, if the pressure increases, if you want to reduce the pressure, generally it's not a fixed thing. If you want to change the pressure based on your requirement, you can change the spring mechanism and you can get a variation of the pressures. So generally, if you want to vary the pressure around 180 bar to 220 bar in a normal cylinders, in a CRDA engine also we have a probability to change the cylinder pressure, injection pressure around 400 bar to 700 bar. So based on your fear, we can change the injection pressures, because in a recent cases, we doesn't use alone of a diesel, we are using the different alternative fuels. So based on that particular point of a fuel property, we can utilize the fuel injectors. Okay, so the fuel is important for combustion process. So that's the reason we are taking the proper atomization. Okay, so for atomization, we are using the high injection rate. This is the fuel injector. So the fuel is injected in an equal distance. So this is happened at a atomization position only. Okay. And next. So cooling system. So here the engine is continuously operated. It increases the cylinder wall temperature. So when the temperatures are continuously increases, so it causes to the blocking of a engine cylinder working mechanism. So that's the reason continuously we need to remove the air from the engine cylinder. How we can remove the cooling effect, or how we can remove the heat? So for removing the heat, we are using different types of mechanisms. One is the air cooling system, and second one is the water cooling system. And some cases we are using air coolant water, coolant aisles also. So based on the amount of heat generated, we can decide the system. So generally in a diesel engines, always we are preferring the water cooling systems. Okay. So how we can circulate the water? So for circulating of a water, we require the pumps, and it's continuously circulated. The cool water is very difficult. For fresh water, we need to supply the water. It's very difficult. So that's why we are using a cooling tower concept. So once that water is circulated around the cylinder, it absorbs the temperature from the cylinder liners, and the water temperature is rises. So what we can do with the hot water? Okay, so that's why we don't do anything with the hot water at a plant. So that's why we would like to convert that water, cool down that water by using of a cooling tower concept. So in the last unit, we are discussing about a different types of cooling towers. Okay, mechanical cooling, mechanical draft systems, mechanical cooling systems, natural draft and the forced draft system. So like that, we can construct a cooling towers for a some diesel power plant which is having the high amount of a water is required and we don't have any facility. Otherwise, if you have some facility of providing a cooling water continuously, doesn't require any cooling towers. Simply, we can utilize the ponds or lakes to continuously enter the fresh air of fresh water. Okay. So, normally in agriculture purpose, we doesn't utilize any additional water setup. We can continuously circulate in the water, and that hot water which is generated in the system, that is sent back to the original system. Okay. So the main important thing is we need to reduce the temperature for maintaining a temperature low within the allowable cases. Otherwise, it have a lag, block the entire engine setup. So continuous water facility we need to provide. And next thing, lubrication system. So it includes the oil pumps, oil tank filters, coolers and the connecting pipes. It helps to reduce the wear and tear of the moving parts. So generally we know that in a diesel engine power plants, more number of moving parts are available. So due to the moving continuously, it causes to the wearing and tearing of a components. For reduction of a wear and tear, or it causes to the more frictional losses also. So based on that, we would like to get a better efficiency, means we need to reduce the different losses. Okay. So the first thing is the frictional losses. So that reason we will provide the lubrication system. So here we are taking the lubricating oil in a tank. So that tank of a oil we are supplying to the sump. So this is the oil sump here. So from the sump we are injecting the oil to the components of a inside the cylinder. Okay. So different types of lubrication systems are available. So later we can discuss about the, what are the different types of lubrication systems in a later stage. And next one is the starting system. So how we can start the engine? So this includes the compressed air tank. The function of this system is start the engine from cold conditions by supplying the compressed air. So generally if you see in the system, in the winter seasons, the starting of your bikes are very difficult because outside the atmosphere, we have a cold air, that means it contains a more water vapor. So that's the reason the starting of a engine is very difficult. So at the time, what we can do for a diesel power plants? So in a diesel power plants, we are using a compressed air. So we need to provide a compressed air. So the compressed air have a high temperatures. So that's the reason the air is very easily heated and the combustion start process is very fastly when compared to the normal process. Otherwise, we are using a starting motors. So we have two types of a starting systems are available. That is the crank start mechanism and the self start. So for a self start process, we need to take a starting motor. So it sucks the air from the atmosphere, compressed air, and that is creating the vacuum there. Okay. So generally we are giving kick to the bike when we are start the bike. So what is the purpose of a kick? So the purpose of a kick is, so inside the cylinder, the suction process starts. So when the suction process starts, so here we are creating some vacuum. Then only the air is entered from the atmosphere to the engine cylinder. Okay. So always the air is moving from high pressure to the low pressure. So inside the cylinder and outside the cylinder, pressure temperature inside the cylinder and outside the atmosphere having same pressure. So then there is no movement of air. So that's the reason we need to create some vacuum space inside the cylinder. So that vacuum is created by using a kick system. Okay. But it is very sufficient for a lower capacity of engines, but it's not possible for the high capacity engines. Okay. So that's the reason we are using the starting motor. So it creates the vacuum inside the cylinder and it is possible to take the compressed air into the cylinder. Okay, that the suction process is completed. So that is the reason to develop the compression suction stroke and start the engine. And the last component in the diesel power plant layout is governing system. So already we discussed that almost all diesel power plants are operated at a constant speed. So, but in your bike system, we are using the different, if you supply the high amount of fuel rate, automatically the speed is increases. But in a diesel power plants, most of the diesel engines are operated at a constant speed. How the diesel engine is operated at a various loads? So generally they are applying the loads continuously in a T-lap. So we are applying the low load condition to the high load condition, that means maximum load condition. So we are varying the load also, the engine is almost running at a constant speed. How it happens? So that is happened by varying the fuel flow rate. So if you supply the fuel flow rate is very high, when we are applying the high amount of load. When we are applying the high amount of load, it always requires the high fuel and maintain the same speed. Otherwise, when we are running the engine without any load, at that time we can reduce the fuel flow rate. How it happens? So by using a governor mechanism, it is happened. So this is a simple governor mechanism here. Okay, so this is the experimental setup here. So this is very helpful to the fuel flow control rate. Okay. So the only thing is we would like to vary the fuel supply system, then only we can contain a constant speed. Okay. So these are the important or essential components of a diesel power plant. Now I would like to summarize the today's class. So in today's class we are mostly focusing on 8 essential components diesel power plant concept. So what are the main components here we learned? So here mainly we are focusing on 8 components. So the first one is the engine. So what is mean by engine? So engine is a device. It converts chemical energy into the mechanical energy. So in a diesel power plant, the engine is the heart of the entire system. So here the chemical energy is converted into the mechanical energy. After that, the mechanical energy is converted into the electrical energy by using of a generator. Okay, for operating this engine, what we require? We require to supply the air. So the second concept is air supply system and supercharger concept. So supercharger, so how we will supply the air? So for a combustion process we require the air. So that air from the atmosphere we are taking, that contains a lot of dust content. So that's the reason first we need to clean the air by using the filters. So like these filters are available. So the air is passed through these filters, and by using of this filter we can remove the dust content in the air. Okay. And also if you would like to improve the efficiency, we are using the compressed air. So that reason we are compressing the air by using of a compressor. Okay. So first we are engine, next one is the air supply, and third concept is the exhaust gases, so exhaust system. So in an exhaust system, so we need to utilize the silencers and some other ducts for removing the exhaust gases from the engine combustion chamber. The exhausts are removed from the exhaust valve. Okay. So it requires a silencers. Okay. So other than this, we required the additionally fuel supply system. So this is also very important. So how the fuel is supplied? Fuel supply system. So in a diesel power plant, so we need to supply the diesel inside the cylinder. So for that purpose we are using generally fuel injector. So what it did by the fuel injector? In a fuel injector, it increases the pressure of a diesel. At that point the diesel is atomized. So the proper atomization of a fuel gives a proper combustion rate. After the fuel supply system, start of injection or starting system. How we will start the engine? So generally we are starting system, we are required the cranking technology. or otherwise in a large capacity of power plants, we are using the a separate motor, okay, starting motor we required, that is a self motor for creating the vacuum inside the cylinder. Self motor is required, and also it requires cooling water. So cooling system is required. So because it's continuously producing the high amount of temperatures inside the cylinder, so that's the reason we would like to reduce the temperature by using of supplying of a air or water. So most of the cases in a diesel power plant, we are using the water cooling system. Water cooling system. And coming to the lubricating system, it is also very important. So why the lubrication process is important? So without lubrication process, it causes to the more frictional losses and it causes to the more tear and wear of a engine components. So that decreases the lifetime of a engine system. So that's why we would like to provide the lubrication for the engine systems. So it increases the wear and tear. Without lubrication process, it causes to the wear and tear. So that reason we would like to provide the lubrication process. Okay. If you have any queries, so just send your mail, okay?